while I cover some important news in regards to open for inspections, in regards to auctions on site, in regards to auctions in room, and what the Australian Prime Minister covered last night. So let's go through this. I'm going to try and remember everything that I wanted to say. And I'm going to start off and say that I want to thank the team at McGrath this morning, which I was able to sit through a briefing on some of the things that they're doing, because they've got hundreds of auctions scheduled. And some of the stuff that they're doing is what I'm going to recommend, and some of the other stuff I'm going to recommend based on other conversations I've had with other people throughout the industry, including New Zealand and Australia. Hi, Kevin. So firstly, I want everyone to listen to me here now. Calm down if you're not calm. Calm down. Out of all the industries, we are still one of the few that can operate not 100% as we used to, but we can still do business. There are others that can't. So calm down, relax, chill. That's the first thing. The second thing I want you to understand is that I have a personal belief and a view that human consequences are far more important than economic consequences. It is a good thing that we do a lot of stuff in a short time to not dampen the curve, but to squash the disease, to kill the monster. Okay? So let's be very clear. That's my personal view. Humans over business. The next thing I want to go on and say, here are things that you need to do, and I've already moved to doing those with auctions. The auctions that I've got scheduled that go past midnight tonight in Australia, we have tried to bring them forward. And I already have a number of those auctions that I'm doing tonight. You can do those auctions. So those auctions have been brought forward and I'm doing it. Another group of auctions have been moved towards private treaty. They have changed towards private treaty. If you still want to do the auction on Saturday and you can't bring it forward and you can't wrap it up, what you need to do is convert it to an online auction. And that online auction can be done a number of ways. One way is that you use the multiple online platforms for auction that have been made available. It might be short notice to transfer that to one of those. I'm not going to mention names because then I'm going to favour. There's lots of them, right? There's lots of them. Another option, which is the option I'll be using, is, and Megan Jaffe from Ray White Remuera, which is the number one Ray White office in the world, is using this methodology, and that is using Google Hangouts or Zoom. How will that look? The buyers will bid from their own home. The auctioneer will be potentially at their own home, or maybe at the property, right? But could be at their own home. The real estate agent can be with the vendor. What happens is, like a Zoom webinar, people are visible. They can see the bids. And what will happen is the auctioneer will facilitate the auction with bids via Google Hangouts or Zoom. The property will sell as per normal under auction conditions. You will then have a choice to actually then go off and have the contract signed by the buyer, the agent goes over and gets the contract signed at their property, or you can use one of the multiple platforms. It might be too much of a step for those that aren't on them, like DocuSign, Adobe Sign, or if you're one of the auction platforms, some of them do have technology where you can sign on a glass screen like an iPad. But I will say that what I'll be doing this Saturday will be simple, and that is what you'll be doing is getting the person to sign the contract and pay the 10% deposit or EFT it. It is as simple as that. As to open for inspections, you are by midnight tonight to change the words to auctions by inspection by appointment. You're to go on to your marketing collateral. Anyway, can I just let you know, at 11 o'clock, by the way, I'm doing a webinar with realestate.com on touching on this and also vendor paid advertising. Lucy is putting the link in the comments below. If you want to join, it's a closed webinar, but they've extended the invitation to those that haven't signed up. It's free. Lucy is going to put the link in the comments. That's at 11 o'clock Sydney time, which is pretty much at 10:25. Let me go back to open for inspections. You're to immediately, and do it sooner rather than later, because it is illegal from midnight tonight. You are to go off and change the words from open for inspection times, and it's inspection by appointment. So the wording you're changing is for auction, auction online, inspections by appointment. How will you do this? Listen carefully. You will allocate internally as an office 2 hours, an hour on Saturday and maybe an hour on Thursday or Wednesday. And what you will do is allow 10-minute increments. So in a one-hour appointment, you will be able to have an appointment, say from 11 to 11:10, 11:10 to 11:20, 11:20 to 11:30, 11:30 to 11:40, 11:40 to 11:50, 11:50 to 12. That's 6 slots, 6 in an hour. And if you do 2 hours, one midweek, one Saturday, you can get 12 buyers through the property. So when people call you up, you say, Mr. and Mrs. Buyer, the time we have available is slot 11:10 to 11:20, 11:20 to 11:30. McGraths are not doing 6 slots an hour. They're doing 4 slots an hour, 11 to 11:15, 11:15 to 11:30. Paul, I'm going to come back to New Zealand in a moment. I want everyone to know what I'm talking about right now is relevant to Australia, where we are not in total lockdown. I'm going to come to New Zealand in a moment. So that's how you're going to do your open for inspections. Now, you will not put on your marketing collateral open 2 to 3. That's going to confuse people. Internally, you'll be doing that. And quite frankly, I don't think you're going to be bombarded in the rush with more than 12 appointments on a property, right? So you can still get through qualified people doing it this way. A couple of other things that I want to touch on, and that is, for those of you that are in areas where you cannot actually go do appointments, I know in New Zealand, where it is a total lockdown, the real estate agents are getting the vendor to actually do a virtual inspection using either Zoom, Google Hangout, or FaceTime. They're actually doing the walkthrough themselves. The vendor is doing that, right? So please understand, going forward, I want you also to get super clear. One of the most important things you can do, and Peter Chuancey, who writes $4 million in GCI from McGrath, said what he is doing right now is starting from scratch with all his buyers, ringing them all up and finding who is still looking to buy, who will buy under the current circumstances. And he's leaving all other unqualified, opportunistic buyers, and he's focusing on the ones that want to buy now. And his stats say it's roughly 3 in 10. You have to understand, don't think the way that you're thinking. There's a group of buyers who are thinking to themselves, this is a good time to buy, there is less competition, and if my job is safe, why wouldn't I buy now when I'm buying something for 10 years, not something for 3 to 4 months? So what do you say to people? What do you say to people right now that say to you, a buyer, like, it's going to crash, shouldn't I buy? Here is simple as this. I'd say, Mr. and Mrs. Buyer, if you think the market is going to drop, maybe you should hang up. What I can say to you is that last week we made 4 sales. The reason we made 4 sales is most of those buyers are buying long term. Most of those buyers are taking advantage of low interest rates. Most of those buyers are actually, what they're doing is taking advantage of all this stimulus, and they're taking advantage of fear in the marketplace. And because they're buying a property long term, they've chosen to buy one now. If you feel like the market's going to drop a lot, right, maybe you should wait. But if you're worried that it's going to drop a little bit, or it might not drop at all, or you're just, thinking to yourself, hey, I'm not quite sure what it's going to do, don't try and time the market, right? It's a terrible strategy, because the only way that you know the market has actually bottomed is when the market goes back up, because you can look and say that was the bottom back then. If you're buying a family home, you should be buying a home based on your life, not based on the market, if you're playing the long game, right? To a vendor that's currently sitting on your pipeline and they're umming and ahhing, here's what I would do. And this is what Megan Jaffe's doing at Ray White Remuera. They're actually, picking, like, I think they've already said, May 14. They're saying, May 14, we're going back. So they're taking the photos. They're putting the properties on the market, and they're saying, we're going to have an auction day on May the 14th, because we have an understanding that by then this thing's going to be over. And they're moving forward, right? And yes, you'll be doing appointments. In New Zealand right now, you'll be doing appointments where they're actually, the vendor does a walkthrough of the property, right? That's what's going on there, right? And you're moving forward and having photos, and you're putting on the websites, open auction on the 14th of May, right? And otherwise, you're going to sit there and have paralysis by overanalysis by trying to work out what's going to happen next. So, guys and girls, I'm going to go and sign off in a moment, but I want to recap that your options, the most important thing I wanted to get out of this phone call is what's happening at the moment. You're to move your properties by inspection, by appointment. You're going to internally work out a slot during the week, a slot on Saturday, 10 or 15 minute increments, take buyers through. Don't try and rort the law. We're going to work in with the law. This is an important subject. We want to save lives, and we want to squash this monster so we can move on in a shorter period than let this drag on for 6-12 months, right? That's the first thing we're going to do. The second thing we're going to do is you have to understand, work with only the qualified buyers, not the opportunistic buyers. The next thing is the auctions that you're going to do. You've got a number of options there. Zoom, Google Hangouts, right? Get on your auctioneer. Get them to actually come and do your auctions today. We've got till midnight to do them if you're in Australia. If not, what are you going to do? We're going to move into moving them as a for sale. I will say, and I agree with Peter Chauncey, having an end date by expression by interest or auction by on-site, auction online with a time and date is a good strategy, because you want to bring things to a head. You want to be working with your A-class buyers and A-class sellers. The other thing I was going to say to you right here, right now, is if you can, any properties you've got, get a deal done with the buyers. The buyers themselves are going to want a deal done if they're motivated. Anyway, guys and girls, at 11 o'clock, I'm doing another webinar. It's being streamed via the realestate.com platform. You do need to be registered. Lucy has put in the comments below how to do that. And most importantly, guys and girls, the main thing is to keep the main thing the main thing. And the main thing, guys and girls, is stay healthy. Stay healthy. Please share this video, by the way, because I think that more people that see it, whether they're a consumer or not, it's going to be useful for them to understand. Could you please share this video?